Hello, Grade Ones. Thank you for joining me today. My name is Robin, and today in numeracy, we are going to learn all about capacity. So let's have a look at what is capacity. Well, capacity is the word we use to describe how much of something a container can hold. It is the amount or volume of liquid a container can hold. So let's look at some examples that we use every day. A 1 liter bottle of milk holds 1 liter of liquid. So here's our bottle of milk, and we can see that it holds 1 liter of milk. That is the volume or amount. A 2 liter bottle of cold drink holds 2 liters of liquid. So over there we can see our bottle of cold drink, and we can see that the amount of liquid in the bottle is 2 liters. And sometimes when we take a bath, we use many liters of water, as you can see. So again, capacity is a word that we use to describe how much of something a container can hold. And the units that we use are sometimes called liters. So let's talk about capacity. Why is capacity important? Well, capacity is important because it tells us how much of something is inside a container. For example, how much cool drink is in a can? So sometimes we want to know how much of something we are drinking, so we can have a look on the can and it will tell us how much is inside. Another important example is we are always told that we need to drink 2 liters of water every day. So if we have a look at the water bottle, we can see how much liquid is inside to know how much we need to drink. Capacity is also important because it tells us if the container we are using will hold the amount of liquid we want to put in it. An example of this is how much water the bucket holds. So if we don't know how much liquid or volume the bucket can hold, we can sometimes cause it to overflow. So that's why it's important to know how much an object or a bottle can hold. Let's talk some more about capacity. We use different words when we talk about capacity. Let's have a look at the pictures and the words. Some of the words that we can use are overflowing, full, half full, and empty. Let's read the sentences together, grade ones. We're going to start over here. And we can see that the mouse is having a relaxing bath. Let's read the sentence. This bath is overflowing. So what does overflowing mean? This means when we have too much liquid in a container and it's too much for the container to hold, the liquid will go outside of the container, or as we say, overflow. So we can see that the mouse has put a bit too much water in the bath. Now the water is going outside of the bath. The second one is, this glass is full. If we have a look at the glass, we can see that the water is all the way to the top of the glass. So we say that it is full. Another example of full would be, if you eat too many sweets or snacks, you will say, my stomach is full. Let's look at the next one. This glass is half full. So if we have a look at the picture, we can see that the water only goes up to halfway of the glass. So we say that it is half full. Another example of this would be if you drink some cold drink and you only drink half of it, you might say to your mom that the bottle is half full, or I have drank half of the cool drink. And the last example is this glass over here. And what do you see, grade ones? Yes, very good. This glass is empty. So someone has drank all of their water for the day. So the glass is empty. You can see that there is nothing in the glass. So the four important words that we just learnt about are overflowing, full, half full, and empty. Let's practice. Let's use the words in the word box to complete the sentences. The first one has been done for you. So if we have a look at the picture over here, what does the glass look like to you, grade ones? Very good. The glass is empty. There is no water in this glass. So we can see that they have crossed out the word empty. Now the three words that we have left are full, half full, and overflowing. So let's look at the next picture. Which word do you think describes this glass of water? Would it be full, half full, or overflowing? Yes, very good, grade ones. This glass is overflowing. And why did you say that, grade ones? Well, we can see that the water is going over the top of the glass and spilling outside. So there is too much water in this glass, which means it is overflowing. Great work. And if we have a look at the next picture, how would you describe this glass? Would you say it is full or half full? Well done. This glass of water is half full. Because we can see that the water only goes halfway up to the glass. Very good work, grade ones. Let's look at the next example. Again, we have a word box of full, half full, empty, overflowing. And the object that we have this time is a vase. So if we have a look at our first picture, I want you to look at the word box and see which word is going to best describe the vase. Is it going to be full, half full, empty, or overflowing? Yes, very good. We can see that this vase is overflowing. And why do we say this, grade ones? Because we can see that the water has gone over the top of the vase and spilt onto the floor. So this means there is too much water in this container. So it is overflowing. If we look at our next picture, how would we describe this vase? Would we say that this one is full, half full, or empty? Yes, that is correct. This vase is half full. And we can see that there is only half the amount of water in the vase. And if we have a look at the last one, which word would best describe this vase? Would you say that it is full or empty? Good work. It is empty. Wow. Great work, grade ones. Keep it up. Let's look at the next picture. This time we have a jug. And the words in the word box are full, half full, empty, and overflowing. If we look at our first picture, which word best describes this jug? Would you say that it is full, half full, empty, or overflowing? Yes, that is correct. This jug is overflowing. And why do we say this, grade ones? Can you tell me? Yes, because we can see that the water is too much for the container and it has spilled over and messed onto the floor. So there is too much water, which means it is overflowing. If we look at the next jug, how would we describe this one? Would we say that it is full, half full, or empty? Good work. This jug is full. Because if we said half full, it would have been there. So we can see it is more than half, so it is full. And the last one, how would we describe this jug? Would we say it is half full or empty? Can you tell me? Fantastic! This jug is empty. So we can see that they have drank all of the water and there is nothing left. Now let's practice. Read the sentence under each bottle and draw the correct amount of liquid for each bottle. So the first bottle, let's read the sentence, grade ones. This bottle is full. The second sentence. This bottle is empty. And the last one. This bottle is half full. So we need to draw the correct amount. Let's do the first one together. The first one is full. So we are going to draw our water bottle nice and full. So the next time you go to the shops, you can tell your parents, "Mom, look, this water bottle is full." Good work. Now, let's look at the second one. The second one is, this bottle is empty. So, are we going to draw anything? No, because there is no water left. And the last one, this bottle is half full. So we are only going to fill it up halfway. So this is about half. And we will color it in up to halfway. So we can see that half of the bottle is left. Okay, grade ones, so we learned about different words that we use when talking about capacity, and these were overflowing, full, half full, and empty. So I want you to go look around your house and practice using these words by looking at different containers which may be empty, half full, or full, or maybe even overflowing. Thank you for joining me today. Until next time, thank you and goodbye.